But all right, okay. I think we can we'll move on. I just wanted to show you guys like a bit of an update, show you what it looks like, show sort of kind of where the animations and the visuals are, which I think are pretty good looking. And then we're currently in the process of sort of fine-tuning all the depth and the hit stuff and some of the kind of playability stuff. So let's move on to the rest of the presentation, since we're not really being a team on here. All right, okay, so that's Marine Commander. Just to show you, basically, to show you it's not cancelled, but it's in development, it exists, and it's all same part of the systems that we're using. So we'll take the time, we're hoping to have that for you guys before CitizenCon. So we did the Star Marine demo here. So I'm going to do a few other updates for you guys. So on the ship pipeline, we've sort of had a new initiative where we're sort of refocusing to get all the ships to you guys as soon as possible, especially the ships we had available in the early part of the campaign. So things like the Caterpillar and the Banu Merchantman and all that sort of stuff, we want to get out to you guys as soon as possible, and some new stuff. So towards the back half of this year, you'll start to see stuff arriving in the hangar and then in space, and hopefully there'll be new cool things to fly around with and play with. The US side is going to focus on Origin, Drake, and the Misk ships, and the UK side is focusing on the Aegeus and the Anvil ships. And actually, that's not 100% correct, because the UK is also focusing on Misk, but I will have to change that. Squadron 42, we're going to talk more about this at CitizenCon and show you some stuff. We finished the performance capture shoot for it, which was 3.5 months. It was a longer shoot than I've done on any movie I've done. And it's going to be awesome. It's going to be fantastic. I'm super excited. I mean, that in itself is going to be a whole massive game. Firefly 42 is working really, really hard on the environment, ships, sounds, and the stuff that I'm seeing is great. And everything that we're doing for Star Marine and Arena Commander, which is sort of the space simulation side of Star Marine, is obviously on the foot simulation, is all going into Squadron 42. So it's sort of all the pieces of the technology we're building help make Squadron 42 at the level that we're going to do it. At the CIG Santa Monica, we're doing the design and programming for Arena Commander and sort of the space simulation side of the game. We're doing the writing and lore, it's where Dave and Will are based. The ship pipeline, we have I think about 6 or 7 artists that work on the ships there, as well as several artists in Austin that work on it. And we do the community and marketing. In Austin, we're doing the Persistent Universe core stuff. We have other people working on the Persistent Universe, like Behavior. Also, we have people in the UK working on stuff as well. And obviously the space simulation stuff, which also works in space in the Persistent Universe, is done by several studios, the LA studio, the UK studio. We do it's the head of our IT and networking. We do the game support in Austin. It's our US QA base, and it's where we do our PR, because that's where David Swofford is based. Foundry 42 in the UK, working on Squadron, there's quite a lot of them, as you can see. Squadron 42, they're working on the space simulation Arena Commander side. Also the ship pipeline that we've talked about. All audio's pretty much done in the UK, except for Jason Cobb, who's one of our audio engineers in Austin. And we do customer service in Foundry 42, as well as the customer service that we do in the LA office. And then our new German office, which there's a few people here from the German office. One, Dan, who's with us, Dan. They're sort of the new addition to the family. It's an incredibly talented group. Our core engine work has been done there. We actually are lucky enough to have some of the people that built Cryengine in the very first place, and they've been fairly instrumental in helping us do some of the stuff that I'm just about to show you. So we're really happy to have them on board. Cinematics has been led out of there by Hannes, who is a visual genius. He's also the guy that was with basically helping the project from the very beginning, because the 5-minute cinematic trailer of Squadron 42 to back in the very early days of the crowdfunding campaign was Hannes's work. So he took all the assets that I was using in my prototype and put that together, which is pretty impressive. It is sort of spare time as well, since his day job at the time was with Crytek. They're also working on some of our newer stuff. So we have some procedural generation stuff that we're working on, which we've talked about. We had a stretch goal. So we'll have some pretty cool stuff to be announcing about. It doesn't mean that we're going to sort of randomly generate for, you know, billions of star systems, but we are using the technique to enhance what we're doing in a crafted manner and sort of allow us to have some pretty cool stuff like seamless transitions from space down to the landing environments. They're obviously making Cryengine sing, since they were some of the people that helped build it in the first place, which is very useful for us. Now to you guys. So our community, we have like 935,000 people, which is crazy. We have 30,000 organizations, which is pretty amazing, especially since, you know, we have a very limited form of the game available right now. It's not like you can venture out into the universe just yet. Over 5 million forum posts and over 216 countries, which just completely astounds me. And it's kind of a testimony to, you know, how you guys have all sort of pulled together and built up. But as you say, numbers aren't everything. So here's a short video of some of the very cool stuff that you guys have been doing. On creating tools to help you guys do more of that. Short term, here's some newer community stuff that we're going to roll out. So the community hub, which is, we'll have a video to explain it, but it's a whole center place for the community to put their content up, sort of discuss it, upvote it. I'm not going to say downvote. But it's a place for everyone to sort of come together and display and congregate. And then the Issues Council is, we've been working on a system in the, to enable everyone that's been doing such a great job in playing the early builds and giving feedback to do it in a sort of more focused manner, so we can sort of distill it down and communicate it back to QA, and then we can get it fixed in the game easier. And we're also going to be doing ship and stretch goal status pages. So here's a short video from Turbulent that sort of explains the community.
Greetings, Star Citizens. My name is Ken Wang, and I'm a senior project manager at Turbulent. Today, we'd like to give you a sneak preview of some features that will benefit you, the community, the Issue Council, and Community Hub.
The Issue Council is a groundbreaking, crowdsourced approach to evaluating and validating bug reports. Not only do you contribute your own bug reports, but also you can evaluate other people's bugs and vote on them. You help decide which bugs will be fixed. There are three main phases to using the Issue Council: contribute, prioritize, and resolve. When you find a bug in the game, simply visit the Issue Council and click on the Add Report button. We want to provide the developers with as much relevant information as we can about the bug. So we ask you for your gaming computer specs, as well as detailed steps to reproduce and expected result. You can also contribute to the issue council by reviewing and confirming other members' bug reports. You can indicate whether you were able to reproduce the bug, or if the bug is invalid or a duplicate. Bugs must be triaged and confirmed by the community before they can be voted on and acknowledged by CIG. The community can discuss bugs in the contributions section at the bottom.